the past 2 years, the war in Ukraine has evolved into something the world has never seen before. Hypersonic weapons, long-range stealth drones, and missile systems that can strike city centers in minutes. And now, a question is rising across global military circles. Will NATO erase Russia from the map? Or will Russia erase Ukraine instead? It sounds extreme, but behind the headlines, behind the speeches, behind every explosion captured on camera, there are real systems, real capabilities, and real decisions that could redraw the map of Europe within hours. Tonight, we break the story down into six segments: FACTA, OSINT, expert insights, and the possible futures this war could lead to. Stay with me. This is not just another update. This is the most important escalation analysis of the year. The first verified fact is simple. Russia has already used hypersonic weapons in this war. The most significant event occurred on November 21, 2024, when Russia launched its new Oreshnik intermediate-range hypersonic ballistic missile at an industrial military complex in Dnipro, Ukraine. Public confirmation came from President Vladimir Putin himself, followed by visual evidence and independent assessments. What makes Oreshnik different? Travels at speeds reportedly exceeding Mach 11. Can carry multiple independent warheads, MIRV. Can deliver pure kinetic submunitions capable of shredding large industrial areas. Hard to intercept due to extreme velocity and trajectory. This missile wasn't theory anymore, it was used. Alongside Oreshnik, Russia continues to employ the KH-47M2 Kinjal, an air-launched ballistic missile frequently labeled hypersonic because of its high flight speed. Kinjal has been documented in multiple attack waves across Ukraine since 2022. Fact: Russia possesses operational hypersonic strike capability, and it has already demonstrated its willingness to use it. Meanwhile, Ukraine has responded with new long-range systems of its own, including its domestically developed Flamingo FP-5 cruise missile, a weapon confirmed publicly by President Zelensky, capable of striking targets deep inside Russian territory. The factual landscape: both sides now have long-range precision systems that can hit far beyond their borders. Open source intelligence has filled in what official statements left out. OSINT on Oreshnik. CCTV and smartphone videos from Dnipro captured multiple fast-moving objects descending moments before impact. Satellite photos revealed scattered impact zones consistent with MIRV or submunition patterns. Debris photographed at the site matched earlier Russian IRBM prototypes shown during military expos. Independent OSINT groups analyzed the footage frame by frame, estimating 36 separate kinetic sub-impacts, aligning with expert assessments from Western research institutes. OSINT on Flamingo FP-5. Ukrainian and international OSINT analysts have documented Flamingo strikes hitting fuel depots, military installations, security service buildings in Crimea and Russian regions, strategic energy infrastructure. Satellite photos released publicly show precise deep penetration damage at facilities claimed to be struck by Flamingo-class missiles. Russia's own Ministry of Defense has indirectly confirmed Flamingo activity by claiming to intercept FP-5 missiles, posting photos of recovered fragments. OSINT confirms two things clearly. One, Russia's hypersonic tests are real and have real-world effects. Two, Ukraine's long-range strike capability is now proven and advancing. This is the first time in European warfare that both sides can strike hundreds or thousands of kilometers beyond the battlefield, and the world can watch the aftermath in real time. Military strategists agree on one point. Hypersonic weapons, especially Oreshnik, are not just tools of destruction, they are instruments of signaling. experts highlight three strategic aims. One, deterrent signaling analysts from the Carnegie Endowment and European Defense Institutes interpret Oreshnik's first strike as a message to NATO. We have new hard-to-stop systems, and we're willing to use them. Two, escalation leverage. By deploying Oreshnik in Belarus and integrating it into ZAPAD 2025 strategic drills, Russia demonstrates a capability to threaten not only Ukraine, but the entire European continent. 3. Political intimidation. Threatening to strike Kyiv's decision-making centers with hypersonic systems creates psychological pressure on Ukrainian leadership and Western governments. Meanwhile, experts analyzing Ukraine's Flamingo program see a new asymmetric balancing effect. Ukraine now has a missile with no Western restrictions. It can hit deep inside Russia. It threatens fuel infrastructure and strategic depots. It forces Russia to stretch its air defenses, consuming expensive interceptors. This turns Flamingo into more than a weapon. It is a strategic disruptor. Simulation, not a prediction, not a fact. This segment models possible outcomes based on expert assessments and public capabilities. Scenario A, Russia escalates with more hypersonic strikes. This could include additional Oreshnik launches against military industrial facilities, high-speed kinetic attacks to overwhelm Ukrainian air defenses. A message aimed at NATO, not just Ukraine. This scenario risks drawing the West deeper into the conflict, politically, if not militarily. Scenario B, Ukraine expands Flamingo operations. If Ukraine continues to gain range and precision, oil refineries, rail hubs, aircraft production sites deep in Russia could increasingly come under threat. That would hit Russia's war economy and potentially push Moscow toward stronger retaliation. Scenario C, NATO and Russia enter a deterrent standoff. With Oreshnik in Belarus and NATO deploying additional Patriots, THAAD, and F-35s, both sides enter a Cold War-style standoff. Miscalculation becomes the biggest danger. One wrong strike could escalate the conflict beyond Ukraine. Again, this is a simulation based on public information, not a forecast. After reviewing the facts, the OSINT, the expert analysis, and the simulated scenarios, we return to the original unsettling question. Will NATO erase Russia from the map, or will Russia erase Ukraine instead? Here is the professional answer. NATO has no declared policy or public intention to eliminate Russia as a nation-state. Russia has no publicly stated policy to eliminate Ukraine, but its military actions aim to reshape its future. The true danger is not that one side disappears the other from the map. The real danger is escalation, a chain reaction triggered by hypersonic weapons, long-range missiles, and political decisions made under pressure. This conflict is no longer only about territory. It is about time, range, technology, and perception. The map won't be redrawn by borders. It could be redrawn by decisions, miscalculations, or responses to long-range strikes. The arrival of hypersonic weapons in real combat, Oreshnik from Russia and Flamingo from Ukraine, marks a turning point in modern warfare. This war is no longer fought only with tanks and trenches. It is fought with long-range missiles, cyber warfare, satellite intelligence, deep precision strikes, and technologies no nation had fully tested in real conflict until now. What happens next will shape Europe's security for decades. This is not just a regional conflict. This is the prototype for future warfare. If you want more deep, verified, non-hyped breakdowns like this, hit the like button, subscribe, share this video, and let me know in the comments. Which system do you want analyzed next? Flamingo, Oreshnik, Kinjal, or NATO defenses? Thanks for watching. Stay informed, stay critical, and stay safe.